see where these elements are in periodic table. Into 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18 consists p-block elements. First, I am going to explain you about the group 13 elements. There are 5 elements: boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, and thallium. If we consider about the group trends, boron is a metalloid and other elements are metals. Aluminium shows amphoteric properties. That means aluminium can act as an acid and also as a base. And gallium, indium, and thallium are metals. The first member of this group is boron. It shows different characteristics than the other members because it shows diagonal relationship with silicon. So I want to show you what is that diagonal relationship. If we see the periodic table, if we take the square from boron, carbon, silicon to aluminium, this is a square, and if we draw the diagonal of this square, it lies on boron and silicon. This is a square and this is the diagonal of that square. So boron and silicon are in that diagonal lines. So these two elements show same characteristics. That's why I told you boron shows diagonal relationship with silicon in group 14. Then all elements in group 13 produce plus 3 oxidation states because they consist 3 electrons in their valence shell. Now we have to consider about the properties of group 13 elements. You don't want to by heart all these values because that is not a part of your A-level syllabus, but you should know the patterns of these values, how they decrease or increase when we go from top to bottom along the that group. First, metallic radius. There's no metallic radius for boron because boron is a metalloid. Boron not form metallic bonds. But other elements show metallic radius. And when we go from top to bottom, metallic radius, here you can see increase. And covalent radius also increase. But there's a small difference in aluminium and gallium. Metallic radius, covalent radius of aluminium is greater than gallium. There's a reason for that, because in gallium it has 3 d10 electrons, and the screen effect of that electrons are low. So the electron shells are attracted to the nucleus, and radius also small well. And if we consider about the melting point, that is also different in aluminium and gallium, because gallium has the lowest melting point, because aluminium shows unusual crystal structure. So that crystal structure has very weak bodies, and that is the reason for the lowest melting point of the gallium. And radius of M3 plus ion also increase. First, second and third ionization energies decrease. So you should know these gradual increasing and decreasing patterns of this group 13. We have to talk about the aluminium, because aluminium is an important element. Aluminium is the most abundant metal in the earth crust, and also third most abundant element in the earth crust. So aluminium is important, and we have to study more about the aluminium. When we expose aluminium to air, it produces aluminium oxide, and this aluminium oxide layer makes resistant layer to further reaction with air. So that's why we use aluminium to most of our products that we use. Due to this impermeable layer, aluminium can be considered as the non-reactive element with air. Then uses of aluminium. Aluminium are used to aeroplanes, vehicles, boats, and also to manufacture saucepans, cooking oils, electrical cables, and door frames and window frames. There are many other uses in aluminium. You can study more about this if you search about the aluminium metal. Then we have to consider about the reactions of aluminium. Aluminium readily react with oxygen, halogens, and nitrogen. Here I have shown you the reactions of aluminium. With oxygen, it forms aluminium oxide. With halogens, aluminium halide. And with nitrogen, aluminium nitride. But aluminium is less reactive than group 1 and 2 elements. Similar to beryllium, aluminium reacts with acid and bases. Aluminium reacts with acid and forms the hydrogen gas, and also reacts with bases and forms the hydrogen gas. There's a special incident in aluminium aqueous ions. Because aluminium ion in aqueous solution expected to be present as hexa aqua aluminium ion. As I show you in this picture, in aqueous solutions, aluminium ion always make coordination bonds with 6 water molecules and form this complex ion. This is the formula of that ion, hexa aqua aluminium ion. That means it consists 6 water molecules. So in aqueous solution, water molecules coordinate to aluminium ion and stabilize by forming this complex ion. This coordination of water molecules occurs through donation by the oxygen atom of lone pair of electrons. Here I have shown that this is the water molecule and a lone pair of oxygen coordinate to that aluminium ion and form this bond. In consequence, the electrons in OH bond more closer to oxygen atom, and the hydrogen atoms have a greater degree of positive than the free water molecules in the solution. So that free water molecules in the solution tend to take the protons from this complex ion, and this makes the aluminium salt acidic in the solution. So this aluminium complex ion start to hydrolysis means removing water molecules. So this is the hexa-aqua aluminium ion, and in aqueous solution that ion hydrolyzes and form the penta-aqua hydroxyo aluminium ion. Here 6 water molecules and here 5 water molecules, because proton is removed and that water molecules turn to hydroxyl ion. Again, this penta-aqua hydroxyl aluminium ion remove another proton and turn to tetra-aqua dihydroxyl aluminium ion. Here you can see that here 6 water molecules and here 5 water molecules and here 4 water molecules. So this is the state of hexa aluminium ion in aqueous solutions. But if stronger bases are present, another proton can be removed. I have shown you here. If another proton is removed, this tetra-aqua dihydroxyl aluminium ion turn to this complex ion. Normally we call it aluminium hydroxide, and it is white gelatinous precipitate. And we can see that because it is a precipitate. With excess hydroxyl ions, again another proton can be removed from this precipitate, and this tetrahydroxyl aluminate complex ion is formed. This one is not a precipitate. This precipitate dissolve again and form this complex ion. After that, we have to talk about the dimerization and dimers. This is a special incident we can see in the group 13 elements, because group 13 elements can have 6 electrons in their valence shell by covalent bonds due to their NS2 NP1 electron configuration. But because of that covalent bond, these elements have incomplete octet, because they don't have 8 electrons in their outer electron shell. So it can react as a Lewis acid. That means this molecule tend to take more electrons, or like to take more electrons and complete their octet state. So These compounds with incomplete octet are called electron deficient compound. And both boron and aluminium compounds tend to form these dimers in their gaseous phase. You have to remember that carefully, because they form these dimers in the gaseous phase, not in the other phases. So this is the structure of dimer in aluminium chloride. In gaseous phase, it forms this structure of dimer.